So your crypto portfolio is down about 70, 80%. You've got 90 plus percent downs in some coins, and you're on YouTube looking for someone to help you out through these tough times. You're not sure what to do. Well, I'm gonna attempt to answer some of those questions in today's video with some general information only. Remember, I don't know your exact scenario. All I can do is provide some general information. And I'm also gonna try and answer some questions related to people who actually have some money ready to go and are wondering if this is the time to pull the trigger and go into crypto if the low is in. But let's first cover through the Bitcoin chart, the Ethereum chart, total market cap 1, 2, and 3, and then we'll go over some coins and discuss a few scenarios that you may be currently going through. If that sounds good, smash the like button, give me a subscribe and notification bell because things are changing every hour at this moment. So let's have a look at Bitcoin. Now, this is the chart I've been playing around for a couple of weeks now using the Fib extension tools with some basic trend lines. And we can see Bitcoin currently is just somewhere hovering around that 618 mark at $35,402. That's the 618 mark that it comes in. Currently breaking down a little bit below it, but some support is coming in. And I did say that I expect Bitcoin to have some serious support in this area here, right there. That's the double bottom and that's the trend line. So lowest I see Bitcoin going in is around 33,500-ish. It's not to say it can't break through this trend. It absolutely can. If it does, the next low would be on the 20th of July. And what's nice about that low is that's the same low we had on the 25th of January too, and early January of 2021. So I expect there to be serious support going from this price where we currently are at, which is just a shy of 35,000, all the way down to about 29,000-ish. Just rough numbers. These numbers can fluctuate a little bit, but like I said, serious support. Now let's have a look at Bitcoin and actually check it out on the hourly chart just to have a look and see. And already you can see on the hourly chart, the last couple of hours, heavy sell-off, but you're already seeing massive pickups and volume, huge volume bars in the hour. We haven't had these sort of green bars in a long time since about late February. And already we're getting really big green gut bars. It's not to say the low is in, it's absolutely not to say it, but you're seeing a lot of buying happening just in the last few hours alone with really big volume, picking it up on the cheap, hoping to sell it later. So that's where Bitcoin currently is. We'll see what happens. Wait for maybe a reversal or something to confirm that the low is in. But even then, things can just drop the next day. So this is just what it's like in the world right now. Any sort of news information can either make or break the market. Obviously, we're very negative. So just be careful with what's happening right now. Ethereum, we'll have a look at. This one's breaking down as well. Almost of a double bottom playing out at the moment. 618 mark coming in at $2,215 US. That's the lowest I see Ethereum going. If it does, next mark would probably be somewhere in that 786 mark, around that $1,928 mark. But it's pretty hard for Ethereum to get there. And this is why Ethereum is actually good, because in my whole portfolio, I've only got one coin at the moment that's actually up, that's actually green, and that's Ethereum. And that's just risk management. That's just coming down to seeing something that's very, very strong and reliable. But we'll get to that in a little bit. Let's just have a look at total market cap one. So this is all cryptos, double bottom playing around once again. And you can see that's coming in around that $1.5 trillion mark. Could go lower. Again, lowest I see it going to is the low from the 20th of July at around that $1.15 trillion mark. Looking at total market cap two, that includes all cryptocurrencies except for Bitcoin. And you can see here another double bottom playing out, lowest again, 21st of July. So you're seeing how all of these charts are playing out in terms of its support and resistance. Next one, total market cap three. So you probably know what I'm going to say here. Double bottom as well. Next support coming on the low that we put in on the June and July, around that $417 billion mark. Now, let's get through some of your questions. The most obvious question out there is, if your coin is down 70, 80, 90%, should you just hold on to them or should you sell them? Now, again, I want to emphasize this. I don't know your personal situation. All I can do is just give you the general gist of it. It depends about the crypto, in my opinion. If you bought, say, Ethereum and you bought at the all-time high, pretend you bought Ethereum on the 10th of November and you are just like, oh my goodness, I just paid, you know, $4,800 for one Ethereum. Is this, am I going to make my money back? Most likely you are, because Ethereum does put in new all-time highs, you know, every so often, and you're probably going to make your money back and it's probably going to do it very well. Same thing with Bitcoin. We all know that Bitcoin is probably going to do another all-time high. Even if you bought at the all-time high about 69K, you're probably going to do it again. Something like AVAX that's looked really, really strong. It's probably going to do it again. If we have a look at, say, Luna, you know, it's tried, it's gotten there. It will probably do it again. You're seeing it look really hold up really well on a chart. If you look at, say, something like Atom, that will definitely hit its all-time high again. So even if you bought it at $44.80 at the all-time high, you've had it one time it hit it in September, almost came pretty close on the 27th of October, again in January, and again in, you know, January again. So it probably will have another time where we'll get there again. It's not to say it's for sure, but I look for strong cryptos and I'm probably like, yeah, this will probably have another shot at going to the all-time high. But say something like Cardano, even though this does have a good shot to get to its all-time high just because they've got a really strong management team, I'm sure they'll have a vibrant ecosystem one day. It's going to take a very, very, very long time for ADA, which is currently sitting at, you know, 76 cents, to go back to the all-time high at about $3.10. It's going to take a very, very long time. But let's start moving to other cryptos now. Let's have a look at something like Litecoin. Okay, the all-time high from last year, or second half of last year, was $292. The all-time high before that was in May 10th, when we were sitting at a very healthy $416. And if you start looking even more than that, when did you hit Litecoin? When did Litecoin hit that number again? You have to go back to 2017. So you're seeing that Litecoin's having a tough time getting to its all-time high. So if you bought in December 2017, you'd have had to hold for about 4 years almost just to get back to your all-time high that you bought at. Maybe you would have made a little bit of profit. That's if you timed it absolutely perfect and you didn't let your emotions get the better of you. So that's pretty much 4 years of just your money sitting there doing nothing, just collecting dust. Doing nothing, didn't even make your return, just negative, and you're just hoping for it to come across. And you have to think, when you finally goes back in the profit, you're probably thinking, this is the moment I've been waiting for with Litecoin. This is the moment I'm gonna make lots of profit. I'm gonna make lots of money. You just get dumped on the next day, and now you're waiting for another 4 years probably for it to get to the all-time high again. It's really, really bad. Having something, okay, Chainlink's another one, right? Chainlink put in the all-time high in May, was looking very, very, very good at around that $52 mark and broke down, wasn't able to get near it. Highest it went to was $38, broken down. And again, if you bought in May, you're just gonna be holding these bags for a very long time. Let's look at something like EOS as well, right? EOS, you know, put in the all-time high in May, and then say you bought it there, you would have had it to wait 2018, basically before it hit it again. So it just looks weak. And now look how far you've broken down. You're gonna have to wait ages for it to go up. ICP is another one. Having a look at this. This coin at the all-time high was about $2,800. You're never getting that back. You're probably never getting close to that. You can just see how far, okay? You can already see how bad ICP has broken down. You're never getting that back. But something like Mana or Decentraland, I can definitely see it going back to the all-time high and testing it just because of the metaverse narrative. Something like, say, Rose, I could definitely see it doing again because it's held up okay. It's not to say these are sure things. Anything can happen, but there's some of them. Say something like XRP. Got in the all-time high in, you know, April. So you're going to be waiting a while. Wasn't able to get there at all the second half of last year. Broken down completely. So there's a few things you're looking at. Number one, how often is my crypto going to all-time highs? So the really best example for this is a Cosmos, right? Cosmos has been able to do that. Atom, it's been able to get to its $44.80 mark a few times. So if you bought there, you're probably going to have another chance to get it. Now, how long is it going to be? I don't know. And hopefully you've got enough money coming from your job or something else that's able to pay your rent, groceries, all the essentials, and you're able to just sit there waiting for your losses to be recouped. What about if you've got something bad like ADA, Litecoin, something like that, that's really broken down heavily and you're just not sure what to do? Well, again, I don't know your personal situation, but you really have to think about two things. Number one, what else are you going to do with your capital? What else are you going to do with your money? If there's something else you want to reinvest it in, what I would say is just putting it back into Bitcoin and Ethereum, because those ones will definitely get you a return, and you'll be able to put it into something safe, or just take the profits and use it for your day-to-day lives if you need it. But the reason why I say Ethereum is because Ethereum will go to an all-time high. It will do very well. And during these uncertain times, this is why everyone loves Ethereum, because it's not going to break down as bad as other cryptos. It's still managing to hold up some sort of level of support and smart buying that are there. How long do you have to wait? No one really knows. If I had to say, a couple months at least, probably 3-4 months, just until we start getting some good news. But we can't predict the news cycle. We don't know what news is happening tomorrow, what news is happening next week, 2 months from now. We don't know. And crypto is very, very sensitive to news. And it just seems like there's a lot of bad news at the moment, and things are getting hit hard at the moment. So think about your crypto. Do you have a strong crypto or a bad crypto? Think about staking it as well, being able to recoup some of those losses just through staking it, a really safe way as well. And thirdly, think about if there's anything else you want to invest with, if it's another coin, a share, stock market, vacation, whatever it is. If it really means that much to you and you think you can get a good return, by all means. But these are if you have the weaker ones. If you have a strong one, you probably might be able to pull up and do it again and get you back to that all-time high. But let this be a lesson for you for the next time to have a plan. And this is one of the things that made me start a YouTube channel was I used to go on YouTube and type in whatever, you know, whatever crypto I wanted to look into. And of course, there'll be some YouTuber who's pumping it to the moon and then I'd buy it thinking that, you know, it's going to do awesome and get me good returns. And then the next minute I know I'm down 60, 70% of my coin. And that's when I start to educate myself and read books and read charts and do all this sort of investing into myself. And that's why I always say with all my videos, it's going to be honest, because every YouTube channel I see, like the vast majority of them, are just pumping every coin to the moon. And I feel so bad for people because there are some people who are really investing money they probably shouldn't have to, and they're going to get burnt just from these YouTubers who are just pumping everything, promising them the world and everything in it, and they're going to get dumped on. And it's quite sad. You know, Filecoin, I did a video on this. If you bought Filecoin at the all-time high, you know, around April, I mean, it's going to be so hard for it to get back to those highs from where it currently is. And everyone thinks this every coin's going to do a 550,000x, but it's going to take a very, very long time to do it. And the opportunity cost of doing it is just, yeah. So like your Filecoin has to go up 1,420% for you to get back your returns if you bought it at the all-time high. It's tough. So think about your coin. Think about what you want to do with your money currently. And maybe you will have to take the loss and just tell yourself it's a learning experience. And this is why people have to learn the hard way with crypto. I had to do that too, where you just make some mistakes. So have a look and see which one of those camps you fit into and think about it. There probably will be a rebound at some point. Maybe you can recover some of your losses, but just clear out all the weak stuff and start rebuilding. If there's any YouTubers or anyone, a friend or something who's told you to buy a coin and they didn't know their stuff, reconsider those relationships as well. Okay, even if it's me, if I recommended something and it's broken down against you heavily and you're screaming at your monitor because of me, then that's fine. You know, unsubscribe. You can just, you know, clear your head and be careful of anyone who's telling you to do otherwise, okay? Next one, the people who actually have money and actually thinking about investing into crypto, what should you do now? Well, look, a lot of cryptos are still bleeding quite heavily and it doesn't look like it's gonna stop anytime soon. We do have a bit of a relief rally, even if, you know, I haven't even looked at the Polkadot chart, but here we go. Yeah, that doesn't surprise me at all. Heavy sell-offs, look at that. Heavy, heavy sell-offs, 24th of February, 25th. So let's have a look at Polkadot. I haven't even looked at this chart yet, but let's just have a look for our chart. And you can see massive sell-offs coming out. So you'll probably see this across most alts because they normally move together. So you can see Engine, again, massive sell-off. I'm just clicking random cryptos here and you can probably see FTT would probably be another one that will be getting hit pretty hard. Yeah, look at that. These are on the 4-hour charts. You're seeing a huge, huge, huge sell-off with a lot of altcoins. Chainlink will look something similar. They're all looking similar, you know? Okay, Chainlink looks like it has a, yeah, there you go, red bar as well. So they're all getting hit at the moment. What should you do? I would personally say just hold on to it for a little bit longer and just wait for things to play out, because like I said, we are probably one news drop away from Bitcoin going to 30K and altcoins getting slashed another 10, 15%. One news report, if America reacts to news a certain way or whatever, one of these major nations, then that can definitely cause a panic in the market and you can probably snag up for a bit cheaper. But nothing wrong with just dollar cost averaging a little bit more and just getting in there at just a few good ones. Which ones? The only two I would be buying is Bitcoin and Ethereum. They're the only two I would be buying, with a caveat to potentially Luna. Luna is another one that just has looked pretty resilient, even considering everything else. You can see how bad other cryptos were going. Luna's down, you know, 0.87% in the last 4 hours. Last 4 hours before that, 7-8%, but still been able to hang around fairly well in its major 50% and hasn't been broken down like other cryptos. And I did say that Luna looked pretty good. The other one to that would probably be AVAX. If we have a look at AVAX as well, I've talked about this crypto plenty on my channel. This one's broken down a bit worse than Luna, but still looking okay. And you still got a lot of support there in the market ready to scoop some up. So those are probably the only four I would touch, but mainly Bitcoin, mainly Ethereum. Those would be the gold standard, with a little bit more into AVAX and Luna. Don't worry about staking or anything like that, any of those rewards. Just think about getting yourself really good quality cryptos that are safe, that aren't going to go against you. Because I promise you, if you haven't felt it, once you see your portfolio drop 60-70% against you, you're going to be happy, or you're going to be wishing, I should say, that you invest into more blue chip cryptos and taking a nice chunk out of those. And then when the bull market's on, then you start moving them to smaller caps, because you'll be able to compound your money faster that way. That's a lot of rambling for this video. I hope it helped you during these times. You can always leave me a comment down below. Just remember, it's all general information. It's not skewed to you personally, but play it out, keep waiting it out. We're probably gonna be like this for a little while, but just dollar cost averaging or waiting for a signal that the trend has reversed, and you'll get some consecutive days of what that will look like. But only four coins I would honestly think about investing in. That's it for me personally. But until then, I will see you on the next video and we'll see how the market looks like. Take care, everyone.